How's it going, guys? So this video is going to be pretty straightforward. It's going to be about an issue that a lot of people, even myself, have come across and you'll probably come across at some point in Windows, but it's got a simple answer, but if you didn't know how to fix it, it's not really something you would be able to figure out in yourself. And that is how to fix if you're plugging in a USB drive and it doesn't actually show up in Windows Explorer under My Computer or this PC. Like, you plug it in, it makes the sound, so Windows is recognizing it, but it doesn't actually show up. Now, there are a few possible reasons for why this might be. Let me go through them real quick, and then later we'll go onto the computer and show you how to fix each of them. It's pretty much the same process for all of them. But basically, first of all, it could be that the drive works completely correctly and there's nothing wrong with it, but for some reason, Windows just didn't assign it a drive layer for whatever reason. That's really easy to fix. The second reason could be that it is either a partition style format that Windows doesn't recognize, like it could be ext4 or something that Linux uses, or it could have no partitions assigned to it at all. That's the second reason. Or the third reason could be that the partitions on it are actually messed up, or simply the drive has not been initialized yet. For example, this would be if you just bought a brand new hard drive off the shelf, you plug it in, it might not be initialized. That takes a little bit of an extra step, but it's still really easy. So we'll go over to the computer and I'll show you how to fix all of those.
All right, so we're at the computer, and let's say you plug in a USB drive like I'm gonna do now, and I prepared a few of these specially ahead of time. You heard it, it recognized it, but nothing new came on here. I know I have a lot of drives plugged in, but no new ones popped up. So what's the deal? On this particular drive that I just plugged in, it's completely fine, but there's no drive letter assigned to it. So what you need to do is go to the start menu and just type in disk manage, and then it should suggest this, create and format hard disk partitions. And you click that. I already have it open because it can take a little bit of time to load. And you'll see this menu, which has been around since, I think, at least XP. And what we're looking at here in this disk manager is at the top, you see a list of volumes, and at the bottom, you see a list of disks. So volumes are basically partitions or divisions of whole disks. And at the bottom, you see the disks themselves, along with all those partitions in each one. So actually, mostly, we're going to be taking a look at the bottom. I think this has some more useful info because you can actually not just see the whole list of disks and the partitions, but you can actually see where those volumes are. And also with the disks, you can see areas that are not partitioned at all. They're basically blank, unallocated, which are not shown in the volumes because they're not volumes, they're blank areas. So both panels are useful in certain situations, but in our case, we're going to be taking a look mostly at the disk one. So really what you kind of want to look for is down at the bottom, and you can see here, this one is the one I just plugged in. And you can see it says healthy partitions of FAT, which is supported by Windows, but there's just no drive letter. So anyway, what you're gonna need to do is look for the actual drive you plugged in. It might not have a name. It might just be called disk 10, and you're just gonna have to basically determine based on the size of it, which one you plugged in, or you can unplug and plug it back in to see which one appears. But anyway, you right click it when you do find it and hit change drive letter and paths, and then you can simply add a drive letter. Let's call it Q. It now has a letter. And when we go back into the Explorer, we can right click and hit refresh. And now there it is. It shows up working fine. And again, this is a case where for some reason it just did not have a drive letter assigned to it, but it was otherwise completely working. Didn't even have to be formatted or anything. All right, the next situation is where there is no actual even partition formatted on the drive. So we can actually simulate that by just deleting the volume. And you can see after it did that, there it says unallocated, so there is no drive letter or partition of any kind. And you can see up at the top, it actually disappeared. So this is one example of if it's not partitioned off even, then it's going to be disappearing at the top, and you have to find it down at the bottom. And this is another case where if I unplug it and plug it back in, let's see what happens. You can hear it still did play the sound. It popped up a thing, but it just is unallocated. So if you hear the thing actually go off, it'll still recognize it, even though there's no actual partition on it. So that'll kind of clue you in that it's at least still working. Anyway, so if this is the case and you plug it in and it says unallocated, what you can do is right click. You have to hit simple volume. Next, go through this. You can just basically keep it automatic. You can assign it whatever drive letter you want. Let's call this one S. And then choose the format for the volume. If it's going to be a thumb drive that you're going to take out and put in other stuff, I would probably recommend either FAT or FAT32, probably FAT32 if it's a bigger drive, or even another one might be XFAT is another possibility. You can name it whatever you want and then just do a quick format. And then after a while, it'll show up. And now it says that it's ready to go. And again, pops up in the Explorer. Now, I should point out, if it says unallocated, but you're sure that it has data on it, then it could be like it's corrupted. And in that case, you might actually have to maybe send it to like a data recovery specialist or something, because I want to make it clear, if you do create a new volume on a drive, it is going to basically wipe it. So it is going to erase all the stuff on it if you create a new partition on it. So don't do that unless you know it's like brand new or it's blank or there's not anything actually important on there. But if you're expecting stuff to be on there and it's showing unallocated or something else, then you might have to consult and get some data recovery specialist to work on it. All right, now another possibility is if the file system on the thumb drive is one that's valid, but it's not supported by Windows, like a Linux one called ext4. So I'll plug one in here. And of course, it's not going to show up in Explorer, but Windows immediately will actually pop up and ask you if you want to format this. And this is one where you have to be careful, because if this was a actual good formatted USB drive that was just created in Linux, Windows is going to pop up immediately and ask you if you want to format the disk. You might not want to do that. So if you know that it's formatted in Linux, then I would not format it. You'll just have to use another operating system to view it or special software. But here's an example where it says healthy partition and it says 14.76 gigabytes, but it doesn't have a name of the file system on here. And I know it's ext4 because I made it myself, but also there was another piece of software I downloaded. So here's a program that has a free version. It's called AOME Partition Assistant. This is one that can recognize ext4, and you scroll down and you can see that this disk 10, 14.76 gigabytes that was invisible to Windows shows ext4 on here. So this is that file system and just Windows doesn't recognize it. So if you know that there's nothing important on there, you could simply delete the volume and then create another regular NTFS or XFAT or whatever volume on there. Just remember it's going to delete anything on there. So finally, we can move on to a final possibility, which is this one that I specially made. So if we plug this one in, again, like all of them, Windows will make a sound recognizing that something was plugged in, but this one is going to look a little bit different than what we've seen before. So this one says disk 10 unknown. This time it says unallocated like the other one did, but if we right click it, it doesn't say you can create a simple volume. You can't create any volume. What's up with that? This is a case where usually this is not going to be for USB drives. I had to specially prepare this USB drive to basically trick Windows into thinking that it's not removable, but this is when it is not initialized. That's why this is showing that. So if you ever have a disk that is not showing in Explorer, and you open the disk manager and it shows unallocated, but you can't create a new simple volume, look to the left and see if it says not initialized with this little symbol. And all you have to do is right click, hit initialize disk, and then you're going to have to choose a partition boot table or boot record and just do GPT. That's like the more modern one. If you need to be extremely compatible with like ancient stuff, maybe master boot record, but GPT is fine. And then you just hit OK. And now it's been initialized, which means there was a partition table written to it. And now it still says unallocated, but now you can see you can create a simple volume now. So just be aware of that. If that ever happens, that might be why. But again, that's probably only going to happen for internal drives, not USB drives. I had to do a special thing to be able to have that happen on a USB drive. But also remember that when I plugged that one in, even though it was not initialized, it was unavailable, blah, 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 Windows still had the sound play. So anytime the sound does not play when you plug it in, it could be a actual hardware issue with the thumb drive where it's just like a broken thumb drive, or maybe the USB port is not working or something like that. Actually, there is a little piece of software that I'm a big fan of called USB Log View. This is from a website called Nearsoft. This guy makes a whole bunch of really useful programs you might have seen before. Anyway, this one's called USB Log View, and it basically lets you see a log of anything that's been plugged in or unplugged from your computer. And this is really useful because sometimes I'll randomly hear something get plugged into Windows, or it'll detect a new device or something, and I'm like, what was that sound for? Well, now you can go in and see what actually has been plugging itself in and out, even though you didn't necessarily do it. So it's just a good way to see if Windows is actually detecting it or if something is actually wrong with it. So yeah, now you just have a little bit better understanding about how this really useful disk management panel works.
So I hope you guys found this video helpful. Be sure to give it a thumbs up and like it if you did. And if you want to subscribe, also be sure to click the bell to enable notifications, because I upload about twice a week, so you don't want those to get lost in all the other pretty good videos you probably subscribe to, I'm sure, but there's a lot out there, so you want to not miss anything. Now, speaking of USB drives, if you guys want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is where I was talking about different USB boot drives that really everyone should have just in case of an emergency where your computer's not working, how you can get booted up with those drives and get it working again. So you can just click on that right there. So thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one.